Hey guys! Guess whom you have forgotten? And guess which game you have forgotten? Yep! I'm returning with a forgotten game. Hello, Fawful is back. Yeah, where to begin? Where to actually begin? I mean, I was absent for a long time. And you have seen I did a lot of German stuff recently, which was pretty nice to actually come back into the YouTube business again. But I also am aware that I definitely not only neglected you guys on the English side, but as well told you some lies, I guess? Let's not call it lies, but I really, really postponed a lot of stuff, and there are so many replays I still have to cast, despite a new patch having been released. So, the actual plan will be, and especially for my clan people it will also be interesting, I will return soon, most likely during the next month, hopefully. I can't promise it though, so it might actually be that this might be another, I don't want to say lie, but in the end it is kind of a lie if I don't keep to it, so, yeah. But basically, I might return next month, and once I finished all these old replay casts, I actually will set up Rock of 3 on a new computer, and from there on, I hope that I can provide better casts for YouTube. And for so long, while I'm waiting that CO Flotsy is actually providing me the map file of LTA 1.44, given that I have to cast one or two replays from that, I have to decide which ones I will cast there. I actually don't know the quality of these, I don't have any description. And I actually don't know if I have even cast that game. So yeah, and that's why we are watching LTF, because Fawful is out of replays for the moment, and most likely there are a lot of other replay files in my file order as well, but I haven't checked it. So yeah, some nice LTF action. With the Alliance creeping. Again, I don't have any plan of that game, how it's working. I can only see that people are creeping and it's really, really team-based. Venzio as a Legion hasn't done anything at all currently. Fast Riders are at tier ascent, have already provided here some nice little defense where most likely the zombie spawn will spawn. Yep, you know what I mean. These plague cauldrons there also will one spawn, they have not prepared for that. And if I'm not mistaken, there is also one around here, in that area. This one also isn't secured. They killed off the Alterac base, so that's at least something. So, Evil might have some hard time. How many Evil players are actually in the game? I mean, we have Orange. Orange has not all too much to do. Oh yeah, and this is the version where they have the Draenei. I guess I haven't showcast this one. Or have I? I actually don't remember. Whatever. And we see the Draenei doing their best thing, which they can do best, with the Colonized Scouts, with the Exodari, with everything. They're just retreating to this place. Tempest Keep, it was. Yeah, with Muru. It should be Tempest Keep. Yeah, Tempest Keep. Again, I'm not good at all. I have watched some Cast of Herald. Actually appreciated watching these as. Yeah, actually watching these Warcraft videos gives you a lot of motivation in returning back to Warcraft, because that's an amazing thing about Warcraft lore, I noticed. Yeah, sorry if I don't focus too much on the game and it's more like a talking thingy where I just talk about a lot of things. But basically the entire Warcraft stuff, it's really, really nice to have that lore. We see, by the way, that the dwarves are clearing out the Blackrock area, so I guess it's naturally that this one has to fall. Yeah, I don't know. In any other universe, let's say for example, what would be a good example? Let's say Aragorn or any other universe. It's really, really hard to motivate you to actually do a thing in these fantasy universe, but Warcraft 3 is really one of these exceptions where I think, hey, I watch one episode of Warcraft 3, one World of Warcraft cinematic, and boom, suddenly back again in the Warcraft mood. It's really a miracle. I don't know how Blizzard achieved that, but they surely did. That's really an effect where I say they actually never did that on their other games. Like, when I think back to StarCraft 2, I mean, I recently watched StarCraft 2 footage, yet after having watched it, I don't felt the desire to actually return back to StarCraft 2, despite me actually having played there in the melee. I guess I wasn't all... Yeah, I wasn't really the best player in the melee maps of StarCraft 2, but hey, at least I played decent, I guess, and that was okay. I really had my fun and I enjoyed it with all the Circlings, Mutalisks, Roaches, especially the Roaches, or any of the Roaches. And yeah, that's what happens. By the way, Vent, do you think that... Oh wait, you have to wait for the portal, I guess, so it's only naturally. Kargus in the meantime... Oh yeah, that's right, they have to fight at that area, so... That might be nice to watch whether T-Damien actually will hold it. I mean, he will hold, and most likely he sent me that replay, and I just have forgotten to cast it because I went inactive. So that's how it's always going. I mean, yeah, that's how always how it goes. I'm sorry, guys. I'm disappointing you, probably. So, yeah, what else can I say? I mean, the first match I really have to watch like this, and I guess it's best that I have chosen LTF for that purpose, given that I really have barely any clue. I mean, I can't really tell what that was. It was Finger of Pain or similar ability which he used here. And even the Treadlords are here. They're sending in a flying squad and they're making pew pew with the Warlocks. And I actually don't know if they can withstand with medium armor. Oh, actually, magic. Magic is not really that good against the Exodaris, so yeah, potentially that's a chance for them to hold. I mean, Vindicator Maraud is also standing proudly there, being like, yeah, for Draenor, for my people, for Argus, which has fallen to the Legion, etc. Oh, and there we see even Kvulsic Dragonslayer getting in there. A nice feast, a lovely, lovely feast. And all the Augurs get killed and Kvul has to escape, before he also gets butchered. Lovely. Meanwhile in the south, oh yeah, we actually could focus a little bit on the south, because I kind of feel like, they haven't established that base, so where's Braun actually? Braun must be Menesal Harbor? Where's Braun? Braun! Braun where's Braun? Braun is, player? Okay, so he's protecting actually Blackrock Mountain, or at least the remnants of Blackrock Mountain. Who's that guy actually? Kapakas, whatever, some name I can't read sadly, because I'm too dumb. Oh yeah, and that's right, and they also got that little land area, so Dragonmore can actually intercept here at this position. That's actually an interesting choice, and I kinda guess for this game mode it makes kind of sense. In LTA I wouldn't recommend it, even though it looks beautiful. I have to say that, at least. It looks beautiful. And if it looks beautiful, that's at least a good thing. And here we have Dragonmore port with the nice Dragon's Press can. I probably highlighted that one as well at some point. It's really, really OP. Also, don't know if it's needed, but yeah, it exists. It always has to exist. Oh, and Falstaff really, really low. Actually wonder what happened here. Has Silverhand actually fended off the defenders? Have they? Did Damien? I actually don't know if they succeeded in their mission, but given that it's the 10-minute mark, they might have. That looks like... I don't know. Kind of looks like that. Because Tempest Keep hasn't fallen. Trenai Haven still existing, so... yeah, that might be it. Ah, okay, he's also telling Godmarat safe, so I guess he succeeded in the mission, because else I guess T-Damien wouldn't say that. By the way, T-Damien, really good player. Also have seen him in the Herald cast so far. And he's really promising. Really, really promising. Really looking forward to see more stuff of his side. And I also like that he's really, really active, and thank you so much for the replays you sent me. Because most of them are actually quite interesting. Not all of them, sadly, but hey, you can't change that. So It's not your fault. I mean, sometimes replays are good, sometimes they are bad, and sometimes you can't even know what the caster is actually thinking about them. Either way, so far when looking at it, it seems like a really pretty safe alliance game for the moment. I mean, in LTF you can say that that definitely looks like a safe alliance game. I mean, if Drangmaw is not securing that position, he might get some problems. He really might get some problems. I mean, yeah, he has secured south, he has saved his allies down there, and they hopefully come through the dark portal, but Lewis really has to hurry, because Yetero and Gorfin shouldn't sit around idle, and holy shit, why is it lagging again, and build some bases around this position? I actually don't... I'm not sure what he's doing. He has two Death Knights here, Yet Heal is already pinging. They need him here at the portal. Unless Kargus, of course, has a portal opener. Yeah, they're pinging. I definitely want to tell him, dude, you're the Shadow Council, you have to open that fucking portal, or else we can't do any shit at all. And thus, Queen should definitely realize it, but I guess Queen is either AFK or has no clue at all what to do. Oshogon, by the way, is still standing. I kind of have the feeling that he doesn't know what to do, which is bad. And he even gets levels for that, but oh no, wait, he's researching? And now he seems to realize what's going on. Either way, we can actually plant over back to T. Damien. As I already expected, not looking good for Pwn at all. Not really looking good for Pwn at all. I mean, Orange tries at least to defend here, but I actually don't know if that will be enough, given that, yeah, there's already the entire Alliance Force here, and I mean, High Elves are also here. I actually doubt they will turn around this thing. Ranger Squad also here. Too many players to face in the early game here. Oh, and there's even a Tome of Intelligence, which they definitely should pick up. Yellow can actually establish here Sundermar, I guess. Well, at least we can see if the Dragon Quest cannon is actually worth it or not. Oh, the Dreadlords also added, so... I actually don't know if they can hold it. I actually don't know. I never have held at Dragonmaw port that extensively, given that when I always had to retreat back to that base, I always considered it lost. But also that one is really, really weird passing, but hey. I'm not Marshmallow mapping, so and of course I'm mapping. Yeah, I'm mapping incarnated, yep. That's totally right, Fawful. You are a map, it doesn't make any sense at all. Don't bother my words. I'm just too confused, staring at this battle, being actually glad that it doesn't fuck up, and given that fucked up thing, I tended to notice that one, recently, quite a lot. Even in the casts Harold provided. By the way, which is also a strange thing, Harold had some casts in 1.42 despite 1.44 existing. Is 1.44 unstable or not really out? I actually don't know. I only know it's on Make Me Host, and that Flotsy will provide it to me, so you can actually hope for the best. Oh, we get a teleport in. I wonder who actually... oh no, wait, that was the retreat with the Astral Walk. So yeah, they're getting away, the Dreadlords. And Pwn also has to get away, else he will get slaughtered. Morgor has died, and Cruel the Dragon Killer is sitting idle here. It's not really looking good at all. Not really looking good at all for Dragonmaw. At least have they opened the Dark Portal. Orange has already lost his second hero. That's right, because Blackrock Mountain died, and Vent was the second hero, yeah. Yeah, but at least they got to Azeroth, so... I mean, they brought forward the war. Pwn on the other hand, I actually don't know what Pwn is doing now. I mean, he has now the Cruel the Dragon Killer here. He has still the Dragonmaw Island, to where he retreated with Necrosh. So... I actually don't know. actually don't know what you're doing now. I mean, he could technically stay with his allies, and I most likely would recommend it in a 6v6, where the alliance is really, really strong, but... assuming that the title will be what the replay is named after, I guess we can expect surprise from all sides. Okay, dwarves? I guess dwarves are talking in a foreign language I don't recognize. I never realized, by the way, that Falstad has a changed portray in this version, okay? Interesting. I actually never really realized that one. Generally, I have to actually look. So many color confusion, by the way. Oh, yeah, we have even Haldor and Brightwing for the Sentinels. So, I mean, these have already 3 heroes, which is quite nice. By the way, anyone can kill off that goblin portal pet, can they? Can they? I guess they can. If they really wanted to, but... yeah. For securing that one CP. It might be worth it, but on the other hand, who knows? It's a pointless relic from LTA, where the Horde was still alive, and I guess Messis is regretting that the Horde is not in LTF. So yeah, bad times, but we can't change it. We can't change it that in the Foremast there are no actual orcs, except for the fell ones. And Yellow is giving commands, commands, commands. Actually, I am kind of speculating what that neutral alliance will be. Most likely, I don't know why, but I get the feeling it will be Dark Iron and Risen, maybe? Huh. It could also be Dragonmaw with Twilight Hammer. Huh. I really wonder, because this is really feeling like one of these games when nobody's doing anything at all. Yes, yeah, Scourge. I mean, that's really the most peaceful Lodowna I've ever seen at the 18th minute mark in this game. I mean, I haven't played this game all too much, but still. This is really, really peaceful. Oh, Quay has, by the way, the Gargoyle Hero, which was also implemented in this version. Stone Spire or whatever it was called. So, yeah. Oh, I'm looking forward in LTA for version 1.45, because they actually changed that bit in LTA and actually gave it here a back entrance, so they actually can connect to Guntrack, which is actually a nice thing. Or, wait a minute, I have to think. Have they actually moved it there? Because, wait a minute, I have to cartograph this thing. Here they placed Winterguard Village. It could be that they moved it up there, so that Tractoron Keep is directly connected with Guntrack, but I actually don't know. It might be the case that they actually just didn't change all too much on that and just made it one circle. So, yeah. Most likely they have a connection here, and that would make Tractoron Keep actually a quite valuable base again. Or at least... yeah, more valuable. I don't know. It will change up some things. Yeah, Borean Tantra also looks nicer in LTA then. Here they also changed the fjord, but I guess you already have seen that in Havel's video. I don't know, I shouldn't repeat things. So yeah. But, unsurprisingly, Alliance... they're even killing off that creep camp, so... oh yeah, that's right, and they might actually launch the plague, but the thing is, they already pushed back the Trenor forces, so I really, really don't know if the plague will be a large problem. Yeah, because as Yellow is saying, they are not prepared. It's really, really simple. They are not prepared at all. Oh, and they even lost already the initiative on that thing. They apparently launched the demon portal there, so that means Legion also has no assault beacon. Which actually means, yeah, they just have to gather around all these plague things, have to wait for the Scourge Invasion Force, and kill it off. And that's it. And they're prepared for that. They already have secured South. They literally possess Azeroth. I mean, the Alliance is already in control. And Evil, they barely have any footholds there. Yeah, they don't have. They don't. They don't have at all. I guess they are too hesitant. Oh, now they launched it. Okay, fair enough. And Nossi Blackfinger also got spawned in, yeah, that place where he's getting fucked over. So much for you, Nossi Blackfinger. Oh yeah, that's right, they also had a Plague Cauldron. Yeah, that one also gets killed off, because they were prepared for that. Even though they have a weak force of knights down there, so I guess they weren't sure of that position. Oh, so there wasn't a Plague Cauldron, I guess. So I was mistaken there, but yeah, there was definitely one. And they're killing off this one. I hope at least with Nasenos Maris. Yeah, that thing is dead. And here's the Great Plague Cauldron. Here they have to kill it. While, there's not so much for the Scourge Force, as I predicted. It just killed that thing off. Just killed it off. And Arthas? Arthas in the process. Oh no, wait. They're down there. With Baron Riven there. Okay, so they actually did the thing. They just teleported down to south. I guess, yeah, okay. Okay, so that's why they prepared the force. Just to have here a foothold at the House of Baroth. Hmm, interesting. Oh no, wait. They also have the Deathgate portal. I forgot. Okay, okay, okay. Oh, and Cut of the Damned also teleport. They could have utilized the Deathgate portal. I mean, what point would the Deathgate portal... whatever. Whatever. Just play the game. Just play the game. While the Alliance is moving to Enderhall, making it kinda like in Azeroth Wars, where the Alliance actually has to fight off the undead, which are located at Stratholme. Even though in Azeroth Wars, the forces were not that big. Holy shit, that Nerubian Air Force, by the way. Quite nice to have. And yeah, of course, they're sending off all the zombies, which get dispelled immediately. And yeah, as T-Damon says, let him go in there. He's probably preparing... Yeah, he's definitely preparing a trap. I thought so already. Which means that if... Yeah. Somebody has to come from that position as well, so they actually yeah, can imprison the undeads within the... how was that? Cadaver? I guess it was Cadaver. Skolomance was the name. Okay, alright. I have it. I got it. I know what the Mighty Wizardry School is called again. Yeah, actually we have a great battle here. While we also have a battle in the south, where the undeads can't decide actually whether they want to break through the Archer Squad or not. Because the Archer Squad is actually defending well. Oh, and Baron Riven there is not looking all too healthy. He's already... Where is he captured? Baron Riven there? I don't see him. Oh fuck, too many units. I guess he's in the middle of somewhere. I see at least Anubarak fighting there, so I guess Riven there should not be far away from him. Yeah, he's tanking a lot. Actually standing here in the middle ground. Oh no, wait, here's there's Riven there, yeah. He's fighting here, straight at the gates of Enderhall. Oh, is that a Galen who's fleeing? Oh, and Lord Garritos also barely escaping. Interesting. Interesting enough. Oh, Arthas at the front lines. Arthas, you should be careful. I guess if you die... I actually don't know what happens if you die. I actually don't know if Blue can get Arthas on the regular way if he kills him. Interesting. So yeah, but the Silverhand is tanking here. I kind of feel like the Scourge is breaking through at this position, given that only Steam Tanks and Dalaran is holding here. Tantric Broadmoor also here, just a demi in this version, but hey, that's okay. I actually wonder if we will ever see another version of LTF again. Oh, and here the Tyrus Fall agents are also blocking the way in case the Undead Heroes try to flee from there. So yeah, they definitely kept away the undead forces from Enderhall. Stonespine is actually trying to break through nonetheless. And even... Yeah, Ludgaritas survives this. They have a lot of heals with the High Elves in the background, and yeah, they should be able to do that. But the undead force is getting melted. Meanwhile, by the way... Oh yeah, that's right, they also have a Plague Cauldron there, which they have to kill off, and they're already doing so. Well, I have to admit that Rivendare still is fighting valiantly at the front. T. Damien still focusing, holy shit. We have to be careful. Let's keep it slow, let's keep it epic, and now the Scourge actually has to retreat because, yeah. The Alliance forces, despite having taken a lot of damages owned by the Visiteers Fall agents running through the Tomb of Uther, they probably have also focused on the wrong position. I mean, yeah, the Tomb of Uther is not active at the moment, but in LTA it would be deadly to actually fight for the Undead at this position with the Alliance being there. Huh. Yeah, and they definitely have to get back to Northwind through the Death Gate, as else might end pretty badly. They killed at least off every peak. Or did they? Yeah, they killed off every peak. Every peak is already gone. What about the Archer Squad, though? What about you? Okay, you retreated to Altarax, so I guess Quay pushed them back a little bit. But, yeah. Hmm. Seems so far like a pure Alliance with Undead scenario, which is quite cool, but pretty imbalanced, because there's only... two evil factions fighting. What about the West, actually? What about the West? I mean, there has to be more to that game. I mean, Rancio is not that inexperienced as a player. I at least know the name. Okay, so he is actually doing stuff here. And Damien is just looking what to do. Oh, and they also overtook Stratholme. So that's also a thing which happened. But, well, they got zombies by events, so I guess that's legit. That's valuable. Weil everything got turned here into Plaguelands, so yeah, that happens. Meanwhile, the Grand Find is still going on. And we're already at the 26-minute mark. Holy shit. Holy shit. That game is not taking all too long, I guess. Yeah, back to Scourge, I guess. Oh, Baron Riven Death Hell. I missed it, I'm sorry. And then Urak buried himself, which you can see on the pathway. let's hope you don't get detected, but given that the Tears Fall agents have vision, I don't think you will stay for long undetected. Damien looking so far fine with Grand Inquisitor Isilin. I actually don't know if he was a Grand Inquisitor at all during that time. When they actually formed the Scarlet Crusade, I guess he became Inquisitor, and before he was just a bishop, or... I actually don't know. He was some important guy, next to Foul Alonsus and other guys. Oh, and Tearsfall agents either teleporting out forces or teleporting in stuff. One of them died at least. But given that the Scourge is pushing, they might teleport out. Or they actually might teleport in forces. It looks rather like they teleported in forces. Which, however, turned out really, really bad. Despite the Archer Squad at least providing some help with the Silver Covenant Hippogriffs and Sylvanas Windrunner. Yeah, T-Damien also building with his militia forces up some barracks and other production lines, so yeah, they can actually hold the Scourge at the other bridge side. That's actually an interesting tactic. I never saw all too many fights around that bridge. Most likely because of the healing aura in LTA here, but yeah, that's quite interesting. I actually can say I never saw that far. So, yeah, and they're reinforcing now via the Death Gates, so Scourge is actually utilizing this position wisely. That's actually good. That's actually good. I never saw them actually trying to invade from that position. I always see them directly rushing to the capital. And once the capital is broken, they actually can hold off. But in this case, I guess Scourge actually found a way, yeah. to actually overrun these structures. I was just, I don't know. I thought it was kind of funny that the undead units just interrupted the build times of the peasants, and the peasants are like, oh no, we can't build there, there are all the bugs running over the pretty fields, oh no. I don't know, it wasn't really that funny, but hey. So, yeah. Scourge on the march. Scourge on the march. It will be a really, really long game. Really, really long. And I'm already tired. Why am I recording this? Probably just to fill YouTube with some English content again. So you guys can actually see some new action, see some new stuff. Even so, you knew it, or should know it already. I don't know. I'm at least glad that this replay feels unfamiliar, so probably I haven't casted it. Oh, and by the way, Prince Galen, by the way, is back again in action. So, hello, Prince Galen. I actually don't know where you were. I'm tired as fuck. And yeah. Aww, look at all these undeads. Ravaging through the lands of Altavak and Strandport and whatever villages lie there across that Altavak area. They could even rush down to Town Mill, take that one down. But yeah, I guess Scourge is just happy to actually bombard Anderhall, take it for their own. Oh, and they even get a new base there. Mm, cool. Cool. Look at that. Sandy is Scourge base. Scourge base from nowhere. They're pushing. They're pushing you back. They're actually pushing you back. I'm surprised. I never would have thought that Scourge could actually push them back. So, props to the Scourge player. What's your name? Cockalone. Oh yeah, Cockalone. I remember your name, I guess. Have I casted that? I actually don't know if I casted that game. I don't think I casted that, because I would remember that. I'm pretty certain I would remember that. And if it's double, then fuck it. Then I'm not better than other YouTubers, then, yeah. It's like reacting to my own videos and comparing them. I actually don't know. But technically it's not really that much work, if you think about it, to cast a Warcraft game. It's more work actually playing it, to be honest. I mean, anyone can be a shoutcaster. Look at me! I have no clue at all regarding Warcraft. And I'm probably a worse player than... yeah. Then you would actually imagine when you see how I'm actually doing all these casts, but I mean, everyone can shoutcast. You can... I don't know. I don't want to drop names or anything like that, but I guess if you have watched shoutcasts from other guys or wherever, you can actually see why I think anyone can shoutcast, so yeah. We shouldn't go too much into detail for that one. So, what has Teal actually done? Teal has not provided all too much except for opening the ground there for Quay to actually get a base there. It's actually not all too much they can provide. Oh, and by the way, they have... Oh no, wait, they just have two heroes at the beginning. I nearly forgot, yeah. By the way, having logically the Skull of Gul'dan and the Terran Sandstrider also being at the front lines, fighting a little bit and then retreating like a little bitch. Yeah.